In an attempt to capture the harsh realities of addiction and drug abuse, films often reside in surrealism, using psychedelic visuals to help explain what the character is seeing, Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas being a prime example. And while this definitely works, I think it inadvertently confines the film's drug element to one dimension. When it comes to making a drug film, the director's approach shouldn't just be how do we show that the character is on drugs, but rather how do we get the audience to feel what the character feels. And in my opinion, the most effective way to portray the perilous terrain of addiction, from the momentary euphoria to the utter despair, is not through an over-the-top visual mess, but instead through clever montage and editing techniques. If executed correctly, a character's drug use can elicit a deeply visceral feeling. The right method can expose its subject, placing the viewer inside the mind of the user, isolating and disorientating them, while simultaneously forcing them to empathise. And a film which does this perfectly is Rocketman. Dexter Fletcher's jukebox musical is littered with these great sequences of magical realism as a way to mirror Elton John's chaotic rise to fame. And at first, it is magical. During his debut performance at the Troubadour, Elton and the crowd begin to float into the air. For a brief moment, everyone experiences complete euphoria. Time stops. While it's unclear whether or not Elton was taking drugs at this point, it is one way or another Elton's first high. Danny Boyle achieves the same effect in Trainspotting 2. After Renton and Sick Boy agree to get high again, time slows as they fall into a dreamlike state. They become fully immersed in the moment. As the drugs fill their veins, we cross-cut into the next scene whilst the music crescendos until they reach their peak. It's an incredibly simple manipulation of time, but the result is unrivaled. The fantasy sequences in Rocketman, however, quickly turn from being an innocent interpretation of a surreal moment to erratic memories of a drug-fueled mind, unreliable and harrowing. What started as a chronological retelling, going from place to place, concert to concert, soon becomes an unhinged, drug-infused mishmash of scenes that bleed into one another. For example, in minutes we watch Elton morph from a broken soul who is unable to love himself, to the star of the show, the great Elton John. Yet his time on stage always seems to escape him too quickly, only for him to regain consciousness and ask,
"Where am I?"
Purposefully fleeting, these fantasy sequences are a way to embody his drug abuse, which is momentarily soothing yet ultimately futile. At the start, performing was a magical moment for Elton, but now it has become a monetary objective for his peers with complete disregard for Elton's well-being.
I'm gonna fucking kill myself.
He goes from an attempted suicide to being ready to go on stage in a matter of minutes. This dichotomy between scenes from ridiculousness to reality, fantasy to fact, is allegorical to Elton's unstable state of mind. He struggles to find agency, and the increasingly frenzied structure, jumping from dreamlike highs to desolate lows, plays as a reaction to Elton's self-sabotage. I think perspective is paramount in terms of getting the audience to empathise with a character. We only see what Elton can remember, so as he begins to forget where he is or what day it is, we are left equally as confused. You find yourself not watching the life of Elton John, but experiencing it. As a result, we feel every hit, every emotional impact, and every insult that gets thrown his way. You can see a similar effect of using perspective to draw empathy in Trainspotting. In the scene where Renton overdoses on heroin, Boyle switches our perspective to Renton's point of view. We sink into the floor, paralysed yet still conscious. It's probably one of the most sombre representations of addiction in cinema. Despite all that has happened, despite the destruction it has caused to his life, heroin is still in control. And as if we are in the midst of a joyous occasion, Lou Reed's Perfect Day plays as a juxtaposition to the disturbing reality. Such a perfect day. You just keep me hanging on. Ultimately, Trainspotting and Rocketman are great examples of films that create visceral moments through their portrayal of drug use. While mixed with moments of surrealism, I found myself most affected by the subtleties, the contrast of shots, a manipulation of time, or simply the perspective we are given. In a film where drugs are ubiquitous, if you want the audience to truly understand the character, you have to put them in their shoes, and both these films do just that.
I thought I was someone else, someone good.